Tiger Woods, what's wrong? Why are you upset?
I don't know, golf is my life, but I am losing my passion. Could this be the end?
Don't be silly, Tiger. What if I told you there's a new way to play golf?
A new way?
Yes. Did you know you could play golf in Minecraft?
Golf in Minecraft?
Yes.
Minecraft?
Minecraft. Hey everyone, and welcome back to my channel. For this video today, I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make your own crazy golf in Minecraft. I created this world back in 2020, and to clarify, this world is a Minecraft Bedrock. No mods, no plugins, 100% vanilla Minecraft. So any version of the game can make their own crazy golf course. And that is what I'm showing you guys today, so you and your friends have something new to play. If you loved the video, be sure to leave a like and share the video around, as you can never have enough crazy golf in the world. And I hate to be that guy on YouTube, but 45% of you who watch my videos aren't even subscribed. So if you could support this channel, that would be awesome. Anyway, let's begin. First things first, there is one special block that makes crazy golf in Minecraft work. Ice. And lots of it. You will need ice to create your golf course, as it will allow your golf balls to glide across the surface. After multiple tests, I have found that an item can glide over a maximum of 10 ice blocks if thrown at the right angle. So when you're building your golf course, don't make the holes crazy long. Firstly, place a line of red concrete to indicate where the starting line is. Then we can start placing down the blue ice. We recommend blue ice, as it's the only ice block that emits a light source, so this could be something you could have in your survival world. Then, when you are making your ice path, we would suggest making it 3 blocks in width. You can make your pathway 5 blocks wide or 1 block thin if you like, but I found that 3 blocks wide seems more realistic. Once you have done that, go to the opposite end and dig a 2 deep hole like so. Place a dispenser facing upwards. Fill it up with fireworks, then place a wooden pressure plate on top so the fireworks will shoot out when the ball gets in the hole. You could also put an end rod on top of a cobblestone wall behind the hole to show where the hole is at a distance. And just like that, you have your first golf hole. It seems very basic, but there are many variations that you can build. You can have a course that goes around an object, over an object, or make it have twists and turns. But if you want to make your golf course more technical and challenging, then listen closely. If you use water and signs, you can decide where you want the ball to go, whether it goes in a hole or in lava. My best example of me using water and signs is on my Mushroom Island hole. The player throws their ball into the hole, and then the water stream takes the ball down, and then the sign cuts off the stream. I then start a new water source, like the water flow, and then cut it off again. I then make another water source and let it flow naturally. By doing this, I'm able to control where the water takes the ball and how far I can keep it going. This is what I call water manipulation. You could also utilize water elevators to send your golf balls upwards. This is what I did on my bamboo forest hole, and as you can see, the ball travels up the waterfall, shoots out, and then the water sends the ball down. On my ravine hole, I used a combination of water manipulation and water elevators by using an elaborate pipe system. On this hole, the player has a 1 in 5 chance of getting a hole in one. So for this, I had to send the balls in unpredictable directions where I had to overlap some of the pipes, which was very hard to do. Now that we have added a fancy touch to your crazy golf course, let's add some hazards. The most common hazard in crazy golf is water, but that's boring. Instead, you can add cacti, fire, and so much more. On my desert hole, the objective is inside the temple, but you have 3 cacti blocking the entrance. The players must carefully navigate the ball around the cacti, otherwise their ball will get destroyed. On my nether hole, the hole is inside the nether fortress, but there are walls of fire that can also destroy the ball too. And if you are wondering how we got water in the nether, Just type in these coordinates and then the water will appear where you are standing. You can add different kinds of risks to your crazy golf game, but how about we add some redstone to the mix? On the Mesa hole, you might have saw in the intro that I had pistons moving certain ice blocks up and down. The initial plan was to make the pistons go up and down at the same time, but I think they work better when they activate randomly. To do this, it's really easy to make. All you are going to make is a redstone clock. You are going to need a random block, 4 redstone dust, 3 repeaters, a redstone torch, and 3 sticky pistons. Firstly, put down your random block and place a redstone torch on the side. Put down 1 redstone dust next to that torch and then 2 repeaters facing forward. In front of the repeater, make a line of 3 redstone dust like so and have 3 sticky pistons facing upwards next to that redstone line. Then place a repeater right here facing back towards the random block, and now you have a working clock that will move the pistons up and down. If you feel like the pistons are moving too fast, you can adjust the speed by extending the repeaters. If redstone isn't your thing, perhaps commander blocks might be an interesting idea. I'm not a genius when it comes to commands, but I do know a fun way to troll your friends. On my mineshaft hole, the player has to choose 1 of 3 paths to take. The spawner path, minecart path, or the ore path. At the end of 2 of these paths is a command block that, when activated, says this line of text in the chat, indicating you must start from the beginning. To get this command to say something in the chat, the command can be found on screen right now. Another way you could use command blocks is by helping people get around. As you can see, each course on my map is divided into their own area. At the end of each hole, there is a wall that I use to teleport people to the next hole. If your golf map is laid out like mine is, this might be useful for you. Or maybe you want to be a bit fancy and add a day and night mode for your map. Just make sure that the area is lit well and mob spawning is disabled. Now that I have told you how the game works, how to make each hole unique, and how you can apply hazards, redstone, and commands, let's talk about design. This map I built is based off some of the biomes in this game. And fun fact, this map pays homage to my very first crazy golf map that I made back on a Minecraft Xbox 360 edition. That's right, I came up with this idea around 7-8 years ago. I was 13. And back then, that map was also based on Minecraft's biomes. I also made other kinds of maps too back then, but we'll talk about them for another video. But you guys can choose your own themes. Maybe you want to do a time travel theme, dinosaur theme, or maybe a Fortnite theme. Just kidding, don't do that one. Hopefully, with everything I have told you guys today, you'll be able to make your own crazy golf courses in Minecraft. So I'm going to wrap the video there, and I really hope you enjoyed the video. If you think this minigame is a great idea, be sure to subscribe and leave a like. I spent around 65 hours making this map, and I streamed it live on my Twitch channel, so if you want to go and check it out, you can find it down below. We're creeping up on 1,300 followers, so if you could spare a follow, that would be great. You can also follow me on Twitter, Instagram, and you can join my Discord too. All of those links can be found in the description. And lastly, we have a giveaway running until April 4th where you have a chance of winning a £20, dollar or euro gift card for a platform of your choice. Click the giveaway link down below and follow the steps to enter. But that is it from me. My name is Hades, and see you later.